Approaching the Pedro Miguel lock. Their delay is not too bad. We're scheduled to be entering the lock about 10 minutes ago, so really not too bad. You can see right beside us on the starboard side there, next to the center wall, two gentlemen have entered their rowboats. They're picking up the lines from the shore and will paddle out to the ship to connect to our lines as well. We will get alongside the center wall here, and we will just keep the ship on this wall until it's our turn to head into the lock once the Hyundai Goodwill cargo ship ahead of us exits. You can also see that arrow on the center pier that I was mentioning as we entered Miraflores. That arrow indicates which lane they would like ships to use. So we'll point to either lane. That's how the canal pilots know which lane to use. Of course, now they also use radios, but initially that green and orange arrow was the only indication of which lane they should be headed for. Even though they use radios today, they do still use that arrow. So you will see it move depending on which lane the ship needs to be in.
Thank you.
trip ahead of us is now moving ahead. They are now an additional 31 feet or 9.5 meters higher than we are. So that ship is now 85 feet or 26 meters above sea level. They will stay at that level, clear across the Panama Canal until they reach that final set of locks at Couture. Soon we will see the ship in the opposite channel next to us. It will move ahead into the locks. We will get connected, and then we will move ahead into our lock. position. You can see the locomotives climbing the hill there with that bulk carrier. That's why they have to operate similar to a tall railway to be able to navigate those hills. The cargo ship in Arley is almost out. So the lock gates will close again. The water level will be lower. And we will enter the lock gate to finish our journey up the mountains of Panama. the lock ahead of us, you can see the lock gates closing, so that water level will be lowered to our level so we can enter our lock gate. In the lane next to us, soon those lock gates will close, and that bulk carrier in the opposite lane will be raised up. Also on our port side, you can see an MSC cargo ship there in the new expanded waterway. And just ahead, you can see that the two waterways come back together. So we actually continue through the canal using the same waterway. After Pedro Miguel, the waterways join back together. Now, if you are interested in seeing more of the new locks, maybe even transiting the new locks, coming up next year and in 2024, you will have a chance to do so on the new Rotterdam. Our new class of ships only uses the new locks, so they'll do one of those partial transits that I was describing earlier. They have three cruises in 2023 that will do that, and about five cruises in 2024. So you'll use the Agua Clara locks on the Atlantic side. I'll point out the entrance to those once we're over on that side. They run next to Gatun locks. But if you did want a chance to sail through the expanded locks, now that you have sailed through the original locks, you'll have a chance coming out to do that on the newest ship, the Rotterdam. Anything that might end up floating away, just make sure you hang on to that. We don't want anything to go over the side of the ship here. Or anywhere we sail, keep the oceans as clean as possible. So please do just keep track of any items you have, any napkins out there. Those often can get away from people, so please keep track of that. They just put a tugboat in the chamber, so it looks like that tugboat will come down and join us as the water level is lowered. And in the lane next to us, it's like the sailboat, the catamaran, is going to join that bulk carrier in the lock chamber.